All right, before we can establish our peer-to-peer connection, there is one last thing. On the server side, we need to enable port forwarding. What does that mean? Well, if you decide to be a server and have other clients come in and create a connection to the outside world, you need to allow your incoming connections from your clients to establish a connection. Now think about it this way. If a client wants to connect to you and you're the server, that client is basically saying, hey, dear server, I am ready to establish a connection. I want to establish the connection with you. And the server's internet service provider, which for me, for example, is Comcast, Xfinity, does not know that there's a connection incoming that wants me to receive the data. And also, my internet service provider doesn't know that I'm going to send out my audio data to that person. It's basically a security measure. So for Jacktrip, the peer-to-peer connection, you will need on the server side to activate port forwarding, which essentially tells your modem and your local area network that it's fine for other people to basically come in and say, hey, I want to create a connection and I am expecting you to first receive my audio, and also I'm expecting you to send me back your audio from your microphone. So what you will have to do is go online or connect to your modem of your internet service provider and basically tell it explicitly that this port 4464 on both TCP and UDP has to be opened up so that the incoming connections and your connections going somewhere else are basically fine, and you're allowing it to happen. Now, sometimes that section is called NAT or even gaming, simply because a lot of games have, you know, the same problem. There's, you know, your firewall and your LAN network that have security measures that prevent just any random incoming connection to happen. But tell it specifically, this game is running on a certain port and I trust this connection and I'm using this for my specific program. Now think of a port as simply being a very, you know, a unique address. So not only is your IP address important, because that generally tells your client, you know, where to connect to, where am I located, what is my network, but then secondly, within that network, which port, like which program, you know, which exact channel do you need for me to connect to Jacktrip? And Jacktrip just seems to be running on 4464. I guess that's randomly chosen. Now, unfortunately, I cannot give you exact instructions on how to set up port forwarding because those menus differ from ISP to ISP. But what I can do is I can show you two examples. For example, if you are with AT&T, you can see there's an article here that I linked below where you basically select your modem. For example, let's say we have this device, and it will create an article for you and tell you to go, for example, here to the gateway settings. And as you can see in the bottom left corner, it tells me that would be a link to 192.168.1.254, which is essentially a link to my modem, my router that's sitting in my living room. And once I'm connected to that machine, I can then choose somewhere in the menu to open my port forwarding. Now, if you're with Comcast, Xfinity, you could go to the following address, internet.xfinity.com, and you can see that it does not direct me to my modem or router. In fact, Xfinity has decided to put the port forwarding section under their online menu. So you will have to log in, probably with the ID and password that, you know, you were given or you set yourself when having received that modem. And somewhere in those settings, I selected NAT and saw something called port activation. So after I added the port forwarding option on 4464, I had to wait for a client to connect. And once that client connected, I additionally had to go in my settings and say, yes, I want to specifically allow that IP address to connect to my machine. However, you might find yourself in an easier situation where you only have to set up port forwarding once and from there on not worry about it anymore. Now, I know that some people have problems finding those options. Remember, well, first of all, you could call your tech support and ask about where to find that option. But secondly, remember that only the server has to activate those ports. So maybe your friend is a little more tech savvy than you and has figured out how to, you know, enable port forwarding. And then you could just from there on connect to your friend, you being the client not having activated the ports and your friend having activated the port forwarding himself or herself. So once you have figured that out, let's continue and see how we can actually start the peer-to-peer connection. All right, now that we have enabled the port forwarding, we hopefully get to the part that is a little more fun, which is connecting to our collaborator. As you can see here, I have split my screen. This is what you would see on your local Mac. You've got your terminal window and your QJet control window. And this is basically referring to your collaborator's Mac, who also has a terminal and also has Jack installed, right? And Jacktrip. Now, the collaborator, let's say the collaborator, your friend, decides to be the server and you are the client. So that collaborator will set up a server and you will connect to that friend. Now, number one, you need the IP address of your friend. Go to whatismyipaddress.com or any other way to find out what the IPv4 IP address of your collaborator is, and you will need that. Now, the first thing you want to make sure is to be on the same sample rate and buffer size. So let's say you and your friend decide to go for a very low one. Let's say 64. So your friend would go to setup and select 48,000 sample rate. Okay, and let's go with 64 frames per period, which is your buffer size. Now make sure your friend hits start so that the Jack audio server is running on his or her machine. While on your end, you also want to do the same thing, right? So you're also going to choose setup, 64, 48,000, separate, okay. So you both have started your Jack audio on your machines. Now your friend will have to set up a server and you want to be the client, right? So what your friend does is say simple Jacktrip-S. Remember lowercase s because it's a peer-to-peer connection server. If it was uppercase S, it would have been a hub server. Which would mean that multiple people can join that server. But for now, let's stick to dash lowercase s and hit enter. Tell your friend to hit enter. And as you can see here, this dialog, you know, again confirming the sample rate and the buffer size and say waiting for connection from a client. And that won't change unless you try to connect. So what you can do now is say Jacktrip dash lowercase c, right? You're the peer-to-peer client. And then type in the IP address you received from your friend. In this case, it's 171.64.197.195. And you can add the dash N1 option, but I guess that's the default, so you don't really have to say that. Enter. What happened now? It looks like we're good. How do you know? Well, on your end, right, it said you just hit enter, and it tells you received connection from peer. While on your friend's end, it also changed from waiting for connection from a client to UDP socket receiving in port 4464, waiting for peer, receive connection from peer. That's great. So now what will happen is you are going to hear each other. The good thing is you're not going to hear yourself back. Remember how in the beginning when we tested this with the Karma service, you heard yourself back? Well, it's easier to not hear yourself back because that tends to distract me. If I play the trumpet and I hear myself, even though it's only a slight delay, I would prefer to connect myself directly. So maybe go to connect and say I want my microphone to also go to my system's playback left and right. So now I can hear my microphone perfectly on both my ears. And also I can double check, yes, my microphone is also sent to that server. It has automatically connected, in fact. And from that server, I also receive a connection. Currently only to my left channel. I might want to also have that sent to my right ear. So now I would be able to hear my friend. And my friend, looking on the right side, could also verify that by looking at his or her connection window. And you can see microphone 1 is also being sent to Jacktrip 1. I don't think that that friend would have a second microphone, so we could also disconnect that to avoid confusion. And then also maybe disconnect this one again, because literally only the one microphone signal that I'm sending to the server is also played back on my friend's left ear and also right ear, if that makes sense. So this way you should be able to have a successful peer-to-peer connection. If it does not work, I think this might be because of port forwarding issues, so maybe revisit the first part of the tutorial and make sure the ports are forwarded correctly. In the next video, we'll talk about setting up a hub server, which also involves port forwarding, but you will have to forward even more ports than for the peer-to-peer connection. See you there.